Hey everybody, this is Des McGarry for IGN.com, and I am teaching you how to get the Daedric Armor, the best armor in the game. It's extremely difficult to find parts of this armor. You need ebony ingots and Daedric hearts. And right now I'm just kind of showing off what it looks like. My character is female, so this is what it looks like on a female character. That is a sword, and we'll come back to that dragon later. So first up, you want to go up here on this mountain to that particular shrine and complete the quest Pieces of the Past. Now, you don't necessarily have to complete the quest. I believe the Daedra that spawn here will spawn regardless of you finishing the quest or not. Actually, you should probably finish the quest because there's two more inside, meaning you can get four Daedra hearts here. So we'll have a walkthrough for Pieces of the Past up on the site. But what you want to do is kill the Daedra, obviously, once they spawn, because when you kill them, you can get their hearts. Okay, so now that those two are dead, you can search them and rip their hearts out. So that will give... Oh, also take that key, because you want to go inside. So now you have their hearts, got some arrows back, and you can go inside and get two more hearts from the people in there. By the way, for the Pieces of the Past quest, I definitely recommend killing the guy. And I say that because you get a really awesome dagger. If you don't kill him, you will not get the dagger. And this dagger that I'm using right now has a chance to kill someone instantly. Obviously, it's not working very well, but, you know, most normal people, it should work pretty well. So, okay, they're dead, and I can take their hearts. And another thing that's in here that you're going to need is ebony ingots. So there's a few, so make sure you loot everything possible and get those ebony ingots. Now, these guys respawn about every every week. So if you just wait a week, like in Whiterun or something, and come back, there should be at least two more people inside. Speaking of Whiterun, let's go back there for a second, because you can get a freebie Daedra heart here. Now, if you run up to this building up here up top, and go inside, you might see a fight or something happening. Just ignore those guys. You actually want to go over here to your right and go downstairs. So once you're in the living quarters, just go straight, and I think you take a right. Yeah, so I went the wrong way. So go all the way down this hallway. I'm looking around for it because I can't quite remember where I saw it was. So go all the way down this hallway, and it's right there on your left on a plate. It's a free Daedra heart. I definitely recommend crouching when you do it, making sure you're hidden. So if there's people in this room, I'd still steal it because they're so hard to find. The next location up is the Dawnstar Sanctuary. Now, you notice I went over it really quick on the map, but there is this door, and it is one of the Dark Brotherhood quests that you can get to open it. There is someone in there that will sell you Daedra hearts occasionally. There's also somebody who will sell them to you at the College of Winterhold. However, if you're an Archmage, they will not sell you anything. It is Enthir, and you just ask him what's not allowed here, and if he sells them to you, a dialogue option will come up to buy them. Unfortunately, because I'm already an Archmage, it won't. Also, back in Whiterun, occasionally Belthor will have some Daedra hearts, but it's extremely rare that a vendor will have some. Instead, we're going to buy his ebony ingots, because they're about as rare. And this is the second part of you know, building Daedric armor that we're going through. Also in Whiterun, you'll notice the blacksmith at War Maidens will occasionally have ebony ingots.
Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs.
And his daughter outside will also have ebony ingots you can buy. They are a bit expensive, so make sure you got some coin. Now, if all that doesn't work, you can go to the Gloomblood Mine, which is located over here by Windhelm. I'm going to mark on the map right about where it is, and I actually had to discover it for the first time. So I'll show you how to do that. As you're wandering over there, you'll eventually see it on the map, and you can see the logo for it here. And you'll run into this person who will tell you to get out of here, or you're not an orc. Well, just don't even pay attention to her, and you know, skip this dialogue option as fast as you can and go right on through the doorway.
You're not an orc or bloodkin, so stay out. We only help our own.
Okay, so once you discover it, you can fast travel back here or to and from here, luckily. And what you want to do is go over the bridge. I went a little bit the wrong way, but I get over there. So go over that bridge there and go into the mine, which is located through their little town, I guess, here. Gloombound Mine, I'm sorry. I'm really bad with names of things. There's so much stuff to memorize for here, so it's kind of hard off the cuff to remember every little detail. But anyway, Gloombound, you hop in here, and right away there is a pickaxe, which you'll need, and a hammer, which you'll need. So grab both. At least from what I've read online, people say that you need the hammer, even though I've always mined with just a pickaxe for iron ore. But anyway, right there by the door, there's an ebony ore vein, so you can get some ebony ore. And this is a great way to also help get up your smithing, which has to be level 90 to do this. We have a video up explaining how to get your smithing to level 90 if you're not sure how to do that. Pretty much you make leather bracers and iron daggers, and you can just kind of spawn that. So now we got our ebony ingots, we got our Daedric hearts. We've waited week after week, and here's all the stuff we can build. We can build Daedric armor, which is level 83. Oh, and don't forget, so you need ebony ingots, you need the Daedric hearts, and you also need leather. So you need some leather strips, which, again, you can buy if you want to. I had enough leather on me, so I just made a bunch. So, okay, my character Arrowface, because she has an arrow permanently lodged in the middle of her skull, is going to build some Daedric armor. So there we go. There's a Daedric battle axe if you're a two-handed character player. We got the boots that start as level 31. A bow. I love playing with a bow and arrow, so I definitely built that. A dagger, you know, if you're a stealth character. Level 33, the Daedric gauntlet. I'm building the full armor set here. So another two-handed weapon, the greatsword. A helmet, which I happened to find it, actually, where we were getting those Daedric hearts before. The Daedric shield and the Daedric sword, because I like playing with sword and shield and bow and arrow. And there is the complete set, complete with arrow in your face. Okay, yours may not have that, but mine does. And now I just decide to go on a rampage. This armor looks so amazing, though. And, you know, it looks great on the female character. And back to that dragon. Let's see how that fight turned out, shall we? Looks like I win. So that's how you get Daedric armor. That's where you get the Daedric hearts, where you get your ebony ingots, and how to build this awesome armor that we're seeing in action right now. And for more tips like this, be sure to stay tuned to IGN.com.